normalise what we do. You can see I'm dressed incredibly flamboyantly like a pirate. If you do see a pirate around, you can think to yourself, oh, it must be a Pastafarian. See someone wearing that collar there? It must be a Pastafarian. It must be a flying spaghetti monster. Many people wonder what we're all about. What can it benefit their life if they were to give up their own heathen religion? If they were to give up their pagan god and instead believe in the one true god of love, the one true god of science, the flying spaghetti monster? Well, that's a very good question. I do have here a list of real world benefits that you can expect once you join the true and living and fastest growing mainstream religion on this earth today. The Church of the Pastafarian, the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster. The very first benefit that you will find is quite easy to see. Number one, Pastafarians do not want to kill you. There are lots of religions on this earth that preach violence in the name of love, that preach peace in the name of war, that preach after God has killed all his enemies, then we will all finally be happy. Well, my God believes in something a little bit different, and it is something more like this. Once the gods start murdering their children, then we will finally be happy. So it's a little bit different, and you know, you can judge for yourself which is more true. There are religions on this earth today that are plotting your demise as I speak. As we sit here, there are people that would love nothing more than the end of this entire civilization and its heathen ways. And of course, they believe these things in the name of a god who calls himself loving. Does your God preach this? Does your God preach violence? Or does your God preach non-violence? Does your God tell you who he would like you to murder in his name? Or does your God teach you that obviously that is the most satanic thing that has ever been spoken? The second reason joins the Church of the Pastafarian today is we do not want your money. If you notice, I have no place to put your coinage or your bills. In fact, I don't like them because of it says on there, in God we trust. And of course, that god they're talking about is either the evil god Mammon from the old and dark Babylonian days, or Jesus, the so-called Christ, who is a bit more bloodthirsty than even the capitalist god. So I don't want your money marked with the name of a heathen god, because I don't believe in that shit. Number three, we do not use scare tactics. We do not invent a hell and fill it demons and hellfire and damnation and weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth and all kinds of every single terrible thing we can imagine, and then say that if your children do not call themselves by our God, then when they die we will of course thrust them down into the fiery pits of hell so that they are too scared to not join. No, nobody's too scared to not join the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster, and everybody that has joined came only for the real world benefits that it does give their lives. Number four, dressing like a pirate is awesome. A lot of religions tell you what to wear, tell you to cover your head, prescribe certain articles of clothing that say only when you wear that is God happy with you. First of all, that's crazy. Creator of snake, hey, why on earth would God prescribe clothing for an exalted monkey? That seems pretty crazy. Secondly, into your brain, so you must read over and over and over and memorize and take these stupid and foolish myths from the past and put them into your head. For we do now know that Moses never lived. Moses was never in Egypt. Job is not a real person. The first real human mentioned Old Testament might be King David. Halfway through the book, and finally gets to the point where anything is real. Moses did not wander in the wilderness with the children of Israel for 40 years eating manna from heaven, because that is obviously horse shit. And while we do have a scripture, we just don't ask you to memorize it, because memorizing mythology in the name of truth is an obvious way to fuck up your brain. Number 9, and this one is very important. My God is the first God that has been proven scientifically. Most gods, especially the blood gods of the old and blood-soaked past, the Bronze Age gods, they teach that God can neither be proved or disproved. And this teaching is, of course, a fallacy, because science is the way that we determine reality, not faith. Your God is ineffable. Have you ever heard that? God is obviously ineffable. Well, why does God reserve the right to be ineffable when we are incredibly effable? We all love going out on a Friday night and getting good and effed and just effing each other. So why does your God have none of it? Why does your God not want any effing whatsoever? He is totally and utterly ineffable. You can't even touch him on his newly appendix. Does your God love us martyrs? Does your pagan God preach hate in the name of love? Do you believe in an Orwellian God who teaches love, who calls himself the Prince of Peace, but teaches that no peace will happen until after the Armageddon, after he ends this world in the greatest and bloodiest and most evil war that you could possibly imagine? Is that how you will pray? Because my spaghetti monster has a different ending for this world. And it goes a little bit like this. So let's compare and contrast. I know that this might be a blasphemy for your God, but I do want to point out that blasphemy is a lie. There is no such thing as blasphemy. The only blasphemy that I can see is organized religion. If I was to say something like, flying spaghetti monster is imaginary, I will not be damned. My God does not mind criticism, for it is with criticism that we are allowed to put our true eyes on things. It is through the scientific process and the criticism of ideas that we are able to take our understanding of this earth and build upon it, and then gift a stronger understanding to our children. And isn't that what we're doing here, right? Isn't that why God the Eternal Father uses that metaphor? Isn't that why he calls himself the Father? Hey, dude.